Good morning, everyone. My name is Yu-Hsiu Lin. I'm going to talk about Chinese satisfaction and turnover rate. And my subject is exploring the relationship between Chinese satisfaction and employee turnover rate using company-wide as a case study. I divided my presentation into 5 parts. I'm going to start with introduction. Then I will talk about tech company overview, iteration review, the challenges faced by the company and improvement solution, and conclusion. First, I would like to talk about introduction. In the backpack world of technological advancement, business, especially in the technology sector, face heightened competition. Talent development has emerged as a pivotal factor for companies to adapt to dynamic environment. Training program play a crucial role in empowering organizational members to tackle job-related challenges proficiently. The study underscores the significance of aligning training content with employee need to enhance satisfaction and reduce turnover rate. Therefore, this study will focus on company-wide and the research subject to understand the current implementation data of educational training and identify any issues that need to improvement. Then, they move on to the key company overview. Taiwan company is one of the major players in the technology industry, specializing in taking and packaging service. Established in 1987, the company currently employing over 9,000 staff. Headquartered in Taiwan Hsinchu City, with a manufacturing facility in Taiwan Valley City, the company has advanced in operation globally by investing in a subsidiary in Suzhou, China. Additionally, it has established business office in Japan, North America, and Singapore. The core service offered by the company revolves around the testing and packaging of semiconductor products, encompassing wafer bobbing, boeing testing, icing testing, packaging, and very related activity. Next, I talk about the company vision. The company has defined its core value as performance, innovation, excellence, and sharing. Next, I'm going to talk about the company educational training system. Company-wide have developed an integrated training system and coaching design process based on the company vision and strategy. The development of training framework computer keep success better, employing critical competency and the analysis of competency level by position. The internal on-the-job training program consists of A category, including new employee training, best skill, professional training, quality training, environment safety training, legal right and obligation, sales development and management training. The code design process involves a new training plan, code objective, instructor selection, identification of target participant, and substantial implementation of code and assessment of outcome. And then they turn to another part, iteration review. Training refers to a planned series of activities arranged by a company to bring about systematic change in attitude and social behavior of employees in terms of job knowledge, skill, or alignment with organizational goals and job requirements. Regardless of this, define training as systematic development of knowledge, skill, and professional ability to individual job task or job requirement. In addition, the term job training satisfaction is introduced, defined as employees fulfilled for a series of planned core activity arranged by organization based on the adaptive knowledge, skill, and attitude required particular task or job duties. The concept integrates the idea of job satisfaction and job training. Designing training model, Chicago Nadler proposed the designing training program critical event model. Consider employee training as a process with 9 steps. 1. Appropriate training need. 2. drug analogy. 3. Confirming training in the visual lens. 4. Setting training objective. 5. Designing training content. 6. Training strategy. 7. Prepare training resources. 8. Implementing training. 9. Evaluation and feedback. According to Lutgen and Sorsen, training satisfaction is cut into a critical factor that, when employees lack intrinsic motivation for learning, puts a threat to organizational motivation and employee retention. Therefore, it is proposed the training beyond enhancing skill required for the job can also contribute to professional development and sales work, leading to increased sales satisfaction. The factor influencing overall training satisfaction include trainer satisfaction, course satisfaction, satisfaction with training content, and learning transfer. The four factors collected impact the overall training satisfaction. And then I'm talking about turnover rate and turnover intention. Turnover intention refers to the formal termination of the contract between an employee and the organization. However, turnover can be categorized into involuntary turnover and voluntary turnover, with the distinction lying in whether it is initially voluntary by the employee. Some scholars argue the turnover intention is often used to measure turnover rate in the workplace and is also an indicator predicting employee turnover. According to the employee turnover decision-making process model proposed by Scholar Mobley in 1997, encompass consideration and thought related to the turnover decision process. They include a factor such as evaluating the career job satisfaction or dissatisfaction, assessing the cost associated with turnover, and attempting to exploit other job opportunities. The model comprises 10 stages of decision-making process and choice related to turnover. Next, I'm going to talk about relationship between education, training, satisfaction, and turnover. According to the past research, there is a highly significant negative correlation between training and employee turnover rate. The satisfaction derived from educational training is deemed crucial for employees to maintain a positive attitude and behavior, facilitating the realization of their motivation and goal. Training and development programs are believed to be indicators of organizational value. In the study by Memo et al., educational training satisfaction from the standpoint of social incentive theory, it captured a factor that can contribute to employee development of fulfillment and a sense of value. Under the factor, employee is given a high level of job dedication, which in turn decreases the probability and opportunity for voluntary employee departure. The training is developed and cultivate employee skill and capability condition then to develop a sense of obligation to organization. Additionally, some research suggests a negative relationship between employee job satisfaction and turnover rate. Therefore, organizational management can mitigate employee turnover by increasing job satisfaction. And then they turn to another part, the challenges faced by the company and improvement solution. Current status and challenges of training in the company. First, issue with new employee training program. According to the 2022 training review report, satisfaction with the new employee training program is the lowest in the system. The 4-day format, internal department member serving as instructor, and the lecture-based teaching may contribute to lower satisfaction. with another good time for web and company to extend. Second, internal channel and code content issue. Basic and specialized training course, such as engineering equipment and production, utilize internal infrastructure predominantly, rely on lecture-based method with minimal interaction. The lack of regular and long-term training for internal channel results in inconsistent teaching quality. Third, training code material issue. Internal trainer often use fixed course material, and there is no systematic review or updating of training material unless a course is scheduled. This lack of periodic evolution leads to outdated and responsive training material. Four, issue in the training process. Observation show the trainee tend to low focus in the latter part of the course. During the satisfaction, some very participants show a lack of theory consideration of the question, leading to uniformly capacity we found without meeting for feedback on code improvement. Fifth, lack of post-training action plan for the management course. Basic training code, such as new employee training, lack of training action plan, and it is only available for management level course. The absence prevents frontline employees from effectively applying core content to their work. The issue in selecting training. Participants are selected based on managerial recommendation or lack of prior training record. Rather than considering employee individual need to devising the demand for specific training content. This may result in participants being unsuitable for the course, leading to wasted training costs and employee time. And then I talked about training issue and improvement. Addressing the current situation and challenges faced by the K company in education and training system. The discrepancy between high training satisfaction and increasing turnover rate suggests that the training content may not be certain employee engagement or alignment with their ideal attitude and behavior. The following improvement and recommendation are proposed. 1. Enhance core content to increase employee participation and post-training job satisfaction. We suggest that the company design core content according to employee need. Before offering a core, conduct a survey to gather feedback on the relevant and helpfulness of the training content to their job requirement. Tailor the core based on the finding to increase participation and satisfaction. Promoting employee professional knowledge, skill, practical application, work dedication, and job satisfaction. Second, implement regular review of training core material. The company could establish a systematic procedure for review core material. This includes pre-course review, review to assess feasibility and post-course review in cooperation feedback from employee satisfaction survey. The approach ensures quality control, tailor training content to employee need, and maintain job satisfaction. Provide regular training for internal instructor. We recommend it to establish a comprehensive training system for internal instructor. The system should cover teaching skill, course material development, teaching method, and interaction with participants. The systematic training approach will improve the reasoning of instruction, feather, intervention between instructor and participant, and enhance overall satisfaction with the training provided. To sum up, by implementing the recommendation in the educational training program, the company aims to assist employees in meeting job demand, enhance their professional skills, and automatically improve job satisfaction within the organization. Therefore, the proposed suggestion for the current setting of educational training course for company-wide aims to elevate training satisfaction, reduce employee turnover rate, and establish a more effective learning environment, further mutual good for organization and its employee. That brings me to the end of my presentation. Thank you for your attention.